Good afternoon. Welcome to Jim Munley's World of Weather. Clicked on to long range weather forecast discussion for September 10th to the 22nd. We're going to first talk about hurricane or tropical storm now, tropical storm Florence, which forecasted regain hurricane status over the weekend. But here it is now. It looks like it's trying to intensify. You can see here convection here, the thunderstorms that are occurring on the west side, also down across south, and a little bit of convection here on the east side. So it looks like it's trying to get itself better organized. Okay, we're going to first show you the pattern that we're expecting. This will be for the 10th. We have here a strong ridge here over the Bering Sea and a trough here. This leads to above normal heights across the eastern U.S. Now what we see here, we have a ridge here and a ridge here, and the models are at a weakness here across the western Gulf of Mexico. And this will influence what Florence does, and it may reach the eastern seaboard during the middle or later part of next week. Now we're going to go back to the other forecast maps. Okay. Let me see if I can get them to move a little bit. Okay, here we go. Here's Saturday. Here's Florence. And then we go into Tuesday of next week. Now we're into Wednesday of next week. And it looks like it wants to go into this part of the... Let me get some drawing on here. Looks like it wants to go into this part of the East Coast. Now, then we go into Thursday of next week. Now the map's decided not going to work. Then we go into Thursday. Oh my God, I just lost the maps again. Okay, let's see if we can reload. Because this is important. Please bear with me. Okay, then we go into Wednesday and Thursday next week. See, it starts going in here, and then see, it goes into like the Carolinas and Virginia. That's the GFS. Now we look at the European. You see Florence right down here. Wednesday of next week, it's further south. And then it starts curving. And then it comes into the Carolinas. This is a Thursday. But it appears now that right now the primary effects will be oceanic effects. And depending on the first and track of the future track, this can still change. The potential landfall can occur anywhere from the eastern Florida Panhandle here all the way up to here, to Long Island. Another scenario will be that as it curves out to the north and east. Okay, heavy rainfall will occur associated with the remnants of Gordon, and this will be primarily across New England early in the week. A persistent onshore flow associated with a trough in the northwest will cause rain across through much of this period. Now, along the east coast, the primary effects, as I was saying before, will be driven by the track of Hurricane Florence. Flooding rains, high winds, high surf, or among others, will be possible. So I got to keep an eye on this. All right, now back to the forecast. All right, we're going to look at the forecast for the 13th to the 17th. The pattern remains generally unchanged with the ridge over the Bering Sea and a trough in the northwest, and there will be two ridges you can see here, one here and one here. So for this forecast period, I am forecasting below normal temperatures for the northwest, and forecasting anomalies are 2 to 6 degrees below normal or forecast, and above normal temperatures are forecast for the remainder of the nation, with the anomalies of 4 to 12 degrees above normal. Again, the highest anomalies would be across this area here. For precipitation, calling for below normal precipitation for the western states, and a forecast on probability of occurrence is 45%. And then we have above normal precipitation forecast for this region here. Probability of occurrence is 45 to 55%. A look at the period for September 18th to the 22nd. And there is some flattening of the flow as this ridge begins to weaken and this trough also weakens, but they're still there. So we still have a ridge of the Bering Sea trough here, and we have above normal heights across much of the nation. So I'm forecasting for this forecast period, still below normal temperatures for the northwest, but anomalies will be lower. They'll be about 2 to 4 degrees below normal, and then the pattern will be transitioning to more of a zona flow, so the temperature departures shouldn't be as great. So I'm forecasting still near to above normal temperatures across the remainder of the nation, and I'm forecasting anomalies about 4 to 8 degrees above normal in the areas that are above normal. And for precipitation, calling for below normal precipitation for this area here, probability of occurrence is 45%, and then I have above normal precipitation forecast for much of the area west of the Mississippi River, and I'm forecasting probability of occurrence is 45 to 55%. So that's it for now. We'll keep an eye on Florence, and we have other systems out in the tropical Atlantic out there. There's a cyclone probability 8, and then another system coming off. So we have to keep a lot going on. So that's it for now. Have a good day.